So this video is about Valkyria Chronicles downloadable content. Since I love the game so much, I just had to get it. You go to the extra menu after you install the content, and there's two missions that were available, $5 each. As you can see, enter the ED detachment content is really short. There's only one mission, while Behind the Blue Flame is totally worth your $5 because it has two missions, but if you beat the first mission in a certain way, you get to unlock a third mission. And if you A rank on all those three missions, as I have done, as you see, you get to get an unlockable mission, which is fantastic. So content wise, Behind the Blue Flame, get it, man. If you love this game, get it. Enter the ED detachment is more of a really just dedicated fan service from Sega. So it's only if you really love the game and you just want so much more out of the game, which I did, Enter the ED detachment is really great for that, because it's still really fun. The great part about Enter the ED detachment is the cast of characters that you'll find on there. I think Sega realized who were the most interesting non-story characters in the game, and so they included those in there. I mean, well, some of my personal favorites didn't make it in, but it's still really cool. I mean, you got, I forgot his name, but the gay Lancer that, I don't know how many of you are familiar that there was actually a gay Lancer in the squad, or person who, you know, has that gay sensibilities. He might not be gay, but, you know, you pretty much get that sentiment.
Oh, honey, don't let her get you down. Must be tough now.
The other characters are pretty cool too. We got a Homer who's a masochist.
Now, order me around. We're awaiting your orders.
Edie, who's like a preppy, you know, she's one of those preppy girls that kind of annoying but really fits the humorous aspect of this mission.
She can't die! No! It's just not! No!
Really, just, there's no really cutscene other than the dialogue boxes you see here. But it's still really fun and entertaining to watch and then fold out. And it's just the, you know, some of these characters, all these characters were only voiced like one or twice in the entire game before the song content. And here we get to see them like with full lines, fully voiced with their own story. And it's just amazing, like really awesome. So if you're a fan of the game, totally get entered the ED detachment. The mission itself is really fun too. There's only one mission, and it's not too hard once you figure it out, but it like all the missions in Valkyria Chronicles, it presents a really unique scenario. You have to defend this one area for like the first three turns, and by defending, I don't mean like the enemy has to capture the base. No, that's too easy. On this one, if an enemy soldier enters the space, like even one footstep in that space, it's mission failure. So like, it's really interesting the way you have to strategize to have your soldiers end their turn at the right exact spot to set up a choke point, in order so that when the enemy reinforcements, they get respawned each turn. This is what makes this mission really, like, it's hard at first because you don't know what to do, but when you figure it out, it's just so rewarding. And of course, after three turns, as typical of the Valkyria Chronicles fashion, it changes things on you. Objectives change because some surprising thing happens. And that's why we love Valkyria Chronicles after all, right? So you get that, and it's just really fun. It's pretty fun, short fan service. Behind your Blue Flame, on the other hand though, if you're a fan of Valkyria Chronicles, it's pretty much essential that you kind of get it, because it just packs so much content. I mean, and simple fact is, people have been wanting, because Salveria is such a cool character, you get to play as her. And for the first time in Valkyria Chronicles, you get to play as the, who was once originally the enemy in the main story. So that's really cool. It's not all positive though. Behind the Blue Flames downloadable content features what I think is the most frustrating and the most brutally hard missions ever featured in this game. Well, the thing is, in these downloadable content missions, there's no upgrade feature. You know, there's no R&D. You can't upgrade your weapons. You can't level up your your squads, whatever. You just have what they give you. And Edie's attachment was okay because your characters are pretty cool. And behind the blue flames, it's your units are level 6, and you think that's okay, but the imperial units you control are awful. They are so bad. Their weapons suck. Their firepower sucks. Their aiming is terrible. And just overall, what you have to work with is just, it doesn't make sense, because in the story, Imperial Army is like this uber powerful force. But no, you're outnumbered and you're always overpowered by the Galleon forces. Doesn't make sense, but it makes things incredibly brutally difficult. The first mission is pretty fun. It's actually easier to A rank than the other way to beat it. There's two ways to beat the first mission, and that's the most coolest part about it. You know, you A rank, that's one way to beat it. The other way is, I'm not gonna spoil it, but the other way is really fun. You have to do some crazy stuff and a lot of strategizing there. It's really fun, and depending on how you beat it, the second mission is different. Well, it's kind of the same, but with different unit placements. And that, you know, that as all of you know, in skirmish and hard mode in Valkyria Chronicles, that changes everything. So, of course, in this one, it also changes everything. And really, they're just so hard. Mostly because the only way to beat the second mission is by A ranking it. Every turn you wait, or, you know, each turn things get harder. More enemies get respawned, and really, you don't get to control Salberia for the first half of the mission. And Salberia is so powerful that this aspect already makes it hard. But the thing is, there's also just so many little variables and aspects and complications that you have to think about. It's just so brutally annoyingly hard. Even after you figured out what to do, there's so many things that can go wrong. Just make sure you're constantly saving at each turn and make a bunch of saves, because you mess up and, you know, it's not cool, because if you saved over the last save that you had because you thought you thought you had everything under your control, it's not very smart. You have to keep a lot of saves. And also, the most annoying thing is that when you get the second mission, you know, where you place your unit is so important, but you don't get the chance to reload that part. Go way back to the part where you get to place the units. So I advise, before completing the first mission, save right there, and so you're able to place the units, you know, because it doesn't offer that. But it's a really, really challenging downloadable content here. I think Sega just wanted to make it as hard as possible, because they probably knew that only the biggest fans were gonna buy this one. As for the unlockable content, I don't know, I figured this is a good thing to show on this video, so I'm gonna give you a little spoiler footage here. But yeah, look at that. It's just awesome. You get to control Salberia as a Valkyria, and it freaking rules. So, I mean, the way you get unlocked content is you gotta A rank all the missions and behind your blue flames out of content, and it's totally worth it. It's so much fun. I don't know, I love this game, so I had to get it, but if you're a good fan of it, I think it's well worth the $5 that it is. Also, the third downloadable content, of course, which I didn't buy because I think it's ridiculous, is the extra hard mode. Of course, big fans of this game probably already know this, but Valkyria Chronicles, it by itself is already hard enough. An extra hard mode for the skirmishes? That's ridiculous. I like the game. I like A ranking, and I like the challenge and all. But I think I'm just gonna replay the game the third time, then buy that downloadable content. But you know, for those of you big fans out there who thought Valkyria Chronicles hard mode on skirmishes was too easy, good for you. There you go, your $5. All right, so that was my video on Valkyria Chronicles on content. If you love the game, totally buy it. It's well worth it. So.